Good day, everyone. Let me introduce myself. My name is Alexander Beznosikov, and I am a first-year student of MIPT. And today, I would like to tell you about my work with Alexander Gasnikov and Eduard Gorbunov. And today, my talk is about how we use land sliding for composite optimization problem, or rather how we use its modification for composite problem where we have zero order oracle for one of the function. Okay, this is a plan of my presentation. Firstly, I would like to tell you about original composite problem, then I will tell you about oracles which we use in our case, and then I will tell some words about how we change our problem for our oracles. And then the second part of my presentation is about main result, what algorithm we use, and convergence of it. Then I will tell you about some application and special cases for this algorithm, for example, for convex optimization with affine constraints and decentralized distribution optimization. Okay, we have a composite optimization problem where X is a compact and convex set with diameter dx. Function g is a good, it's a convex and L-smooth in our set. And function f is not good, it's a convex, and we don't know about its L-smoothness. We all only know that its gradient bounded by constant m. Okay. For function z, we have oracle with gradient. For function f, we don't have oracle with gradient, but have only zero order oracle and with stochastic noise xi and systematic noise delta. And we know that delta is bounded by constant delta. And for xi, we know that this fourth moment is bounded by constant b. And for our problem, we used stochastic approximation of gradient f, something like this. And vector e, here is e, is a random vector from uniform distribution from the Euclidean sphere. Okay, to solve our problem with our oracle, with stochastic approximation of gradient, we use not function f, but its smooth version, f big. And we have smooth problem. Okay. To solve this problem, we use the modification of gradient sliding. Here is the external procedure when we compute the gradient g and gave it to the internal procedure where we use this gradient and in this function and change only gradient, stochastic gradient of the function f. And make some iteration with frozen gradient of g and change only this one. Okay. And the main theorem of our article is that we have convergence of our methods something like this, and it's similar with results of LAN, but we have constant n in this one and constant p with star. Constant n is the dimension of our space, and constant P is bounded of the first norm of unit vector or in Euclidean sphere. Okay. And for corollary, we have that we can make convergence, but for original problem, and the change is that in previous one we don't have this one. Okay, and if we have that constant delta and constant B is something like this, we have convergence and oracle hardness of G and for F like this one. Okay, let's talk about some special cases. For example, if we have Euclidean norms, constant P is 1, constant C is 1, and we have oracle calls for gradient, stochastic gradient of F, something like this. It's very similar with Lanz, is one change of it is constant N in this. Okay, and if we have the first norm, constant P is something like this, and we have this oracle hardness for our problem. And if we X is complex, simplex, probability simplex, D of X is equal to 2. And hardness will change without D of DX. Okay. Okay, let's talk about convex optimization with affine constraints. Okay, we have this problem. We try to minimize function F, maybe something very bad function, but with constraint AX is equal to 0. And we can rewrite this one to penalize problem like this. Okay, in this problem we have function F and function G, but in this way. And we can use our methods to compute the honest gradient of this one and the stochastic gradient of F. And we have convergence like this to F, or to hardness of G and hardness of F. Okay. And for decentralized distribution optimization, this problem, we can rewrite it like this. It's a problem, it's a affine constraints, and we can rewrite it like this. And try to use our methods for this, for a new problem. Okay? And we have some convergence for this problem. Okay. That's all.
Okay, so are there any questions?
Yeah. I have a question about one assumption that was mentioned at the beginning about the fourth moment.
Fourth
about,
moment.
So you require it to be bounded. And,
okay.
Like,
this one. Yeah.
Yeah. Is there like any intuition behind this assumption, or it's just some technical thing that we need?
It's technical print with what we need. What we need in proof. Firstly, we need the second moment, but first moment is enough, and we change it to the first moment.
Did you consider any other approximations of the gradient?
This one?
Yes.
Yeah, we used only this. Maybe in the future we change this approximation, but I think it's not. Won't change the convergence of the method.
Seems that we cannot improve the rate of convergence because this corresponds to lower bound, both in communication.
communication steps and both in order to call. So why do we change the approximation if we obtain almost optimal one, maybe up to the ring factor? So maybe for practice, I don't know, but from the theoretical point of view, there is no need to be. Moreover, if you replace the minus f tilde x minus re, you don't write minus re and change 2r by r, so you obtain simple so finite difference instead of gradient. So this doesn't work. It was unexpected, yes, because there are at least two ways how to approximate it partial derivative on the direction e. First way is this one. Second way is term is just f tilde of x, yes.
Mm-hmm.
And the second one is much worse than first one. The reason is we don't have smoothness, and if we use this approximation, the probability that we obtain something bad is almost zero. But if we use another approximation, fx plus re minus fx, so if x is a point of no smoothness, for example, absolute value of x, and x is 0 point.
Mm-hmm.
So unfortunately, theory doesn't work good in this case, because in principle, x can be a very bad point, the point of non-smoothness. And this approach doesn't allow this situation, because typically for convex function, almost all points are points of smoothness. And this is this is well known results, Rademacher theorem or something like this fact is used here, and this is a better approximation than, but the quality of these two approximations are the same. Just capital O of L. I mean in smooth case, in non-smooth case. So the reason of the rebound, the force moment, is to apply concentration of measure inequality for some function on a sphere. So we investigate concentration of some function, and this bound on the stochastic term allows us to obtain something we need in calculations. If we don't assume this, unfortunately, we cannot obtain the desired accuracy of the rate of convergence. This is not our idea. This idea belongs to Ahmad Shamir and was proposed just 2 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Not too old the idea, but this direction is very popular since middle of the 50s, as far as I understand. Maybe Alexander Yurievich correct me and say that one century ago, somebody in Russia. Okay.
Do I get it right that you obtain the optimal rates for this property and this decentralized setting is just like an application of?
Okay, decentralized, it's only application of this method.
Mm-hmm.
And we only change the convergence rate for this one, for this problem.
By the way, since we have time, maybe I comment one thing about one sliding. By the way, this is one application of one sliding. For example, the problem Alexander considered is such a problem. He solved the problem f of x min under the constraints w of x equals to 0, because he has such a situation. Constraint equivalent to x1 equal x2 equal xn, and this function is a sum type function. 1 over n, sum k from 1 till n, fk of xk. So this is a problem formulation. This is distributed optimization. We have a problem with the same x, but we split, since we have some network, we correspond to the network Laplacian matrix, and we rewrite a standard classical optimization problem as a problem of this type. Then Alexander assumes that we have only gradient-free oracle, that is, without any gradient of this function. And each node can deal with only its own function. For example, k nodes can deal with k function. And then he rewrites this problem with penalty function methods and rewrite it as follows, like y square epsilon x w x, because this is equivalent to square root of w x equals to zero, and based on the advanced result in penalty function methods, we can prove that if we solve this problem with accuracy epsilon, so we obtain two epsilon solution of this problem. So it is sufficient to solve this problem with desired accuracy epsilon. And to solve this problem, we have to use split oracle. I mean, after split oracle, I mean two different type of oracle calls. This oracle return us only a value of function because according to assumption, we don't have gradient. Each node can calculate only a value of function. So, since that, we can calculate only value of function. But this term is smooth enough, and we can calculate a gradient. But gradient of this function up to a constant factor is just matrix vector multiplication. But this matrix vector multiplication is nothing more as communication, because I have my matrix that corresponds to graph Laplacian. Matrix vector multiplication is matrix W is such a matrix that has zero elements. For example, this element of the matrix is zero, and this element is minus one. And this allows us to interpret this matrix vector multiplication as communication only with neighbors. For example, if I consider E a node, and I calculated I component of this vector, it's just it can be calculated only by communication of this node with this one, and nothing more. So I have two different oracles. First oracle is gradient free. This is this oracle, and second oracle is gradient, full gradient oracle this time. And I am interested in how many oracle calls of first type I have to do, and how many oracle calls of second type I have to do. And the answer is, okay, if I have, gradient-free optimization, I know that the best possible way to solve gradient-free non-smooth problem is m is the Lipschitz constant of this function, and m square, r square, epsilon square. In Euclidean setup, and this bound is a bound for oracle calls. It cannot be improved. As for communication steps, it is a number of oracle calls of this type. And if I consider this problem separately, so the desired, since this is condition number of this problem is just maximum eigenvalue or minimum eigenvalue, and this again this relation called condition number. He is lambda max W, lambda min plus W, the minimum greater than zero eigenvalue. And so the rate of convergence, according to fast gradient dynamics, is square root of he up to logarithmic factor. So the number of communication steps independently of we use gradient method or gradient-free method is just this quantity. And the number of oracle calls is just this quantity. M is the space, the dimension of X, RN. So I guess it's rather interesting because this is lower bound for full gradient procedures, and for gradient-free procedures we have the same result for condition number. And here we have a number of oracle calls. So the fact Alexander proved is yes, we indeed have such a situation that we can prove that combination of these bounds is really optimal, and we reach a lower bound in terms of communication steps and oracle calls. And we used sliding, not smooth sliding I described, because this guy is not smooth, But smooth sliding with zero order oracle. This is very nice motivation why we start to consider such an application. Different oracles and different assumption about smoothness of curves. So this is distributed optimization, one of the applications. Sorry.
Okay. So I have one question. In the first couple of lines of product formulation, you assume function g is bounded gradient, right?
Alexander, what is it here?
Okay. This one.
Right. So f is smooth and g is.
This one.
Oh no, f.
F is bounded gradient and g is L smooth.
Right, but then in the application to distributed optimization. That function is also strongly convex.
What? This one. This one. Yeah.
So you have more. Here you just assume g is convex and smooth, but in the application you also have strong convexity.
Strong convexity, and I think we can work in this case with strong convexity in the future, maybe. Okay. Alexander said that we can. Use this case when we have one of the functions is stronger convex.
So you will get a better result
yes.
for the general case.
Right? I think yes.
Do you think this can be generalized to different types of oracles? So not only zero order and first order, but maybe different combinations, like second order and first order, or first order and second order. Like for some, let's say for...
When we use first order and first order?
I don't know. In this case, F, you compute zero order
oracle, yeah.
And G
is first order.
So maybe this can be generalized to F first order and G second order. Maybe G is easy to compute hessians, or the other way around, like any form of combination between two different oracles.
Maybe we can combine the classical paper of LAN is we have first order and first order oracle. I think with the second order oracle we can use it, maybe. I don't know exactly, but maybe.